Hello friends, welcome to again Rajdeep School Kodinal. Now we are approaching to our next chapter, that is chapter 15, probability I am going to start. In 9th standard we have seen probability. So in mathematics generally we come across the sums that answers are fixed. Whether 3 plus 5 you go to calculate or your friend is going to calculate, it will be same. But what is probability? Probability is different thing. Here the results are not fixed. For example, I am taking the situation that in rainy season, whenever there are clouds in the sky, we cannot predict that day whether it will rain or not rain. Some persons will say that yes, definitely it will rain in the evening. Some will say no, it will not rain. So what happens sometime? The answer here is not fixed, so here we cannot predict the results. So in such cases, probability concept is used. So in case of such experiments, whenever we do experiment like tossing a coin, if you toss a coin, results are fixed. But either you will get head or you will get tail. So only two possible results are here. So whenever we are going to perform any experiment under some conditions, and you will get possible outcomes or some results. So such possible outcomes we will get by performing some trials we have to do here. So tossing a coin one time, two time, three time, you will get different results. Sometime you will get head, tail, or repeatedly you will get tail, or head. These answers are not fixed. So if you are going to perform experiment under same conditions, here the possible results are not fixed. So these results we will call as outcomes. And for each event, surely we will get two or more possible outcomes. And these outcomes always have same chances to occur. Suppose we have toss a coin, we have two results, either head or tail. So probability of occurring head and probability of occurring tail, both is same. If you are not getting head, definitely tail will be there. So either head or tail you must get after tossing a coin. So head and tail, these are single possible outcomes. We can say that after performing experiment, if you toss a coin for getting head, the event becomes elementary event, and getting tail becomes elementary event. So elementary event will give you the possible outcomes of an experiment. And now we will see what is theoretical definition of probability that we have seen in 9th standard also. So let us denote any event by E. Let E be any event, then probability of any event E we will denote by P of E, that number of outcomes favorable to E. Favorable means the event we have described, that we should get head in this or we should get tail in this. So that favorable outcomes we have to count and divide it by total number of possible outcomes of the experiment. And in this case, you can calculate probability of any event. You can have more than 2, 3, 5, 10 events also. Like whenever we are going to organize sports, in that lot of events are there. In the same way, we can have more than 2 events for any experiment. And now we will see types of event. So first is complementary event. Here we will see that if head is not occurring, tail will appear, and if tail is not occurring, head will appear. So probability of getting head, if I denote E by probability if, and if head is not head means probability of E will not consider, its complement will be A. If head is not occurring, tail will be occurring. So here not H means it will be the complementary event of this event. And such type of events, happening of E and not happening of E are denoted by E and E bar or E and E dash. E and E dash. Such events are called complementary events. Next type of events are impossible events. For example, the sun rises in the west. This is the impossible event, and probability of impossible event is always zero. This you know always. We have seen in lower classes also. And next is sure event or certain event that is to be going to happen 100%. So in this case, we can have the sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. This is sure event. Here probability of sure event is always 1. And last thing I am going to tell you about the elementary events. Now these outcomes, occurring of head and occurring of tail, are elementary events. So probability of occurring H, if I note by 3 of H, and probability of occurring tail if I note by P of T, this is what one time only we are getting. Total number of possible outcomes are 2. Here one time we are getting, total number of possible outcomes are again 2. So half plus half we are getting 1. So sum of elementary events of all possible outcomes of any event is always 1. So in this way we can have the more than 2 events. So if E1, E2, E3 up to EN are the events, elementary events, then P of E1 plus P of E2 plus P of E3 plus P of EN is equal to always 1. So this is our discussion about probability. Let us solve one example here. So lot of experiments we can perform, and total possible outcomes we can show by the sample space. That sample space we should know always. For example, tossing a coin. One time only 2 outcomes are here. Sample spaces H and T, and tossing a coin twice, and it is same as 2 coins tossed at a time. And so in this case you will get 4 possible outcomes, and sample space here will be HH, HT, TH and TT. Then tossing a coin thrice, and it is same as 3 coins tossed once. So sample space here will be HHH, HHT, HTH, HTT, THH, THT, TTT, TTH and TTT. So here we have got 2 outcomes, 4 and 8. So number of possible outcomes in this case will be double, and again double. If you cross a coin 4 times or 4 coins once, you will get 16 possible outcomes. So I am solving one question depending on this only. Find the probability if a coin is tossed thrice of getting. Now I am giving you the events. First, all 3 heads then at least one head. So these are my two events. First event is all three heads. Students, if coin is tossed three times, we have these possible outcomes. Total number of possible outcomes are 8 here. Here our sample space is ready. All three heads, if you see, only one time it is occurring. So let E be the event of getting all three heads, and therefore P of E in this case will be 1/8. So this is first, and for second, at least one head. Now in this case, at least means one head is allowed and more than one head is also allowed. So 1, 2, and 3 heads, such outcomes we have to take into account for this question as a favorable outcome. So what are the favorable outcomes? One head and more than one head means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 possible outcomes we have this for this second event, and so probability of second event is 7/8. So in this way you can continue and solve the questions related to probabilities. So now I am giving you the review of the chapter, the important concepts, so that you note properly, and we will be meeting and solving more and more questions. So this we have to note. So these are our key points. See, here E is our event, probability of any event by the definition, number of favorable outcomes upon total number of possible outcomes of the random experiment. M denotes the favorable outcomes and total number of possible outcomes. So probability of any event is always between 0 and 1. Then this is happening of the event, not happening of the event means E and not E. Sum of P of E and P of not E is always 1, means these are complementary events. Sum of such complementary events is always 1. So if 1 is provided, you can obtain another. Happening of E is equal to 1 minus happening of not E. For any event, probability always lies between 0 and 1. This is very important. Your answer for probability of any event should not be less than 0, means probability is never negative and probability is never more than 1. Then probability of sure event is 1, probability of impossible event is 0, and sum of probabilities of all elementary events is 1. So these are your key points. Isko zoom karo abhi fast.
So friends, I hope you have understood this chapter very nicely. You solve more and more questions. I will help you. You can see the worksheet and go through textbook, solve textual question. Only one exercise is there and it is also very easy. Just go through the concepts very clearly first of all and then solve the questions. Create a sample space. This is a sample space I have created for tossing a coin one time, two time, three time. This if you keep in mind the trick how to create a sample space for tossing a coin. This H we have to take two times first of all, T also. Then in front of H put H and T. Put H and T in the same way. Again this HH I am writing two times, HT I am writing two times, TH two times and TT. Again put HT, 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 HT in front of us. So 2, 4 and 8 possible outcome. In this way you can get for 16 and 32, but at this level we are involving up to 3 times tossing a coin. So thank you and have a nice day ahead and study well. Stay at home, stay safe.